Hello, this is Ravi Kumar. I am going to talk about what ontogenic cyst definition, classification, general features of cyst and more common dendrogenic cyst and OKC. Definition: according to grammar, cyst is a pathological cavity having fluid, semi-fluid or gaseous contents and which is not created by accumulation of pus. It's frequently but not always lined by epithelium. Coming to general features of the cyst, this most of the time the small cysts are asymptomatic. Once start growing, become infection, results in the formation of abscess, cellulitis, osteomyelitis and leads to sinus formation. When the cyst enlarges, it may cause some cyst may cause tooth displacement, resorption of the roots, paresthesia, and most of the cyst will cause expansion of the cortical plates. Coming to the classification of jaw cyst, odontogenic, it developmental and inflammatory. Coming to developmental, OKC is more common and odontogenic cyst, eruption cyst, gingival cyst of infants, gingival cyst of adults, lateral periodontal cyst, calcifying odontogenic cyst, glandular odontogenic cyst. Coming to inflammatory, radicular, residual, paradental. Non-odontogenic, nasolabial cyst, nasopalatine duct cyst and globulomaxillary cyst. OKC, odontogenic keratocyst. The cyst arises from the rest, cell rest of the dental lamina. OKC accounts for 3 to 11% of all the odontogenic cysts. That is second most common cyst. This is the only cyst which starts from infants to older age. That is 70 years also it may occur. And most common site of this cyst is body and the ramus of the mandible. Most of the time the small lesions, small cyst are asymptomatic and when it starts bigger, it causes pain, swelling and extra sinus opening. Sinus opening is the more common peculiar feature of OKC. And compared to all other cysts, when it enlarges bigger, it will grow in a buccolingual expansion. But this is the only cyst which grows through anterior-posterior direction within the medullary cavity. Buccolingual expansion is less. When the cyst, you see a multiple OKC cyst, means you have to suspect Gorlin syndrome or nevoid basal cell carcinoma syndrome. Coming to radiographic feature, it's a well-defined radiolucence and the peculiar feature is it has a corticated margins. When it's bigger, when it's growing, it produces a multilocular radiolucency. And 20 to 40% of the impacted tooth is associated, unerupted tooth is associated with the OKC. Coming to treatment wise, so it has the highest recurrent rate. So that before they are telling us a odontogenic, it is considered to be a tumor because of its aggressive behavior. And very very important is you have to go for peripheral osteotomy, inoculation with application of corneal solution or cryotherapy, marsupialization, and recurrence rate is very high, 30%. So follow up for 5 years is essential. Next is other dendrogenous cyst, and another name is follicular cyst. This is the first common odontogenic developmental cyst. The cyst is formed by the accumulation of fluid between the reduced enamel epithelium and the impacted tooth. It surrounds the crown of the impacted tooth and it is attached to the neck at this cemento-enamel junction. So if the impacted tooth, 10% of all the impacted tooth, if it left inside, it may convert to dendrogenous cyst. And making up to 20% of this, all the odontogenic cysts. OKC is 3 to 11%. This is the more common cyst making up 20%. And the more common impacted tooth is, which is affected is third molar and maxillary canine. Coming to the ideal age group for the development of dentigerous cyst is 10 to 30 years. When it's slow, smaller, it is most of the time it is asymptomatic, and when it is enlarged, may produce facial asymmetry without pain. And so as a peculiar feature, displacement and root resorption is common compared to other odontogenic cysts. Sometimes this cyst may displace the mandibular third molar to the inferior border or to the upper ramus. When you aspirate, you may obtain yellow color fluid. Radiographic features. It is most of the time it is a unilocular. It is always unilocular. When it is big, it appears like a multilocular and associated with the crown of the erupted tooth. Based on the radiographic appearance, you can treat a relationship between the crown and the cyst. It has three varieties. One is central, next is lateral, and third is circumferential. Central means the cyst, the impacted tooth, which will be projected inside the cyst. And the lateral, most of the time it is associated with the mesioangular impacted tooth, the radiolucency which covers the one side of the mesioangular crown and the lateral border completely. And circumferential, partial lit crown and the entire root is involved. Along the root, the radiolucency is involved. Coming to treatment, surgical removal of the cyst is recommended. Compared to OKC, the recurrence is very, very less, and the tooth, the impacted tooth, is also recommended to remove. Normally, if it is smaller cyst, enucleation is enough, or bigger, you have to go for marsupialization. And compared to all other cysts, the lining of the dentigerous cyst, long-standing lining of the dentigerous cyst, may transforms into ameloblastoma, squamous cell carcinoma, and sometimes it may transfer into intraosseous mucoepidermoid carcinoma. This malignant tendency, transforming of the malignant tendency, we all think dentigerous cyst is the more common, but the residual cyst is the highest potential to transfer into malignancy. So once again, I'll repeat it, just a short form. OKC is a cyst which grows anterior posterior direction. Most of the time it will form sinus opening, and with very less buccolingual expansion, and it has an aggressive tumor, so recurrence it is more. So osteotomy, peripheral osteotomy, or applying a corneal solution and enucleation is must. And this dentigerous cyst has peculiar feature, buccolingual expansion, root resorption is more common, and it can transform into intraosseous mucoepidermoid carcinoma sometimes, and the dentigerous cyst may displace the impacted tooth, all those things. Thank you for patient listening.